Will using a password vault thwart a keylogger? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. If you're not getting my weekly newsletter, Confident Computing, in your email inbox every Tuesday, go visit askleo.com/newsletter and sign up today. More tips, tricks, and answers like this one in your inbox every Tuesday morning. So let's jump right to the question. Leo, if one uses a password filler, such as RoboForm or LastPass, and your computer gets infected with a malware keylogger, can it pick up your passwords when you aren't actually typing them in? If not, this makes a very good case for having an encrypted password filler such as RoboForm or the others you've mentioned in past columns. Unfortunately, the answer to this one is both yes and no. Using a password vault can in fact bypass certain types of keyloggers. However, not all keyloggers work the same. And as I've said so many times before, keyloggers are just malware, and malware can do anything. Let's see what I mean by that. You can't assume that a keylogger works a particular way. Like I said, yes, there are keyloggers that only log keystrokes. No keystrokes, nothing to log. Great. In principle, it sounds awesome. However, keyloggers can often work in many other ways. The ways include things like watching the clipboard to see what's traveling through the clipboard in case your password vault happens to use the clipboard to transfer information from the vault to the website you're logging into. They could be monitoring the input fields on the web page. So rather than watching keystrokes fly by, they're watching, oh, this field just got some data. Let's snag that data. No keystrokes were involved, no keystrokes were monitored, but the keystroke logger, the key logger, still managed to see what was entered because it was looking at entry fields. There are hundreds of different ways that a keylogger can log keystrokes without actually logging physical keystrokes. That's really, really important to understand. So what that means is that while you might successfully bypass keystroke loggers that do only log physical keystrokes, you haven't bypassed the rest. Ultimately, the most important thing to realize about a keylogger is that if you've got a keylogger on your machine, you have malware on your machine. And malware can do anything. And that anything can be monitoring any of the data that flows through your system, regardless of the path it takes. It can do anything like capturing screenshots as you go. It could be recording video for all we know. There are so many different ways that malware can capture this information that it is not useful to look for ways to bypass specific types of malware. What you need to do is prevent malware in the first place. And that, unfortunately, is really, really boring. Right? That's the stuff we've been saying over and over and over again. Be skeptical. Have good anti-malware software. Don't click on links that you don't know where they're taking to you. Don't open attachments. The number one way that machines get infected these days, if you're not expecting an attachment from someone. I mean, basically practice good internet safety and avoid malware in the first place. Keyloggers are just one form. And they themselves are so many different kinds of malware that any type of avoidance mechanism won't avoid all of them, and in fact, probably won't avoid most of them. Now, I still want you to use a password vault, absolutely, because they enable part of what I've just suggested you do, better security. When you increase your overall security, you increase your resilience to things like malware, things like keyloggers. When it comes to password vaults, they enable you to use long, complex passwords that you can't possibly remember. They allow you to use those long, complex, unmemorable passwords differently on every site you have. They just enable a level of password security that is so important these days that I can't suggest not using a password vault. But using a password vault to bypass keyloggers? No, that's not a reason, because a password vault may bypass some, but absolutely will not bypass them all. Hope that was helpful. I hope that clarifies what's going on. For updates, for related links, for comments and more, visit askleo.com/6372. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.